Hi, everybody. This is Randy Suits with a letter and a song. Our letter for 21 April is Sometimes She Expresses Anger. My darling Eve, occasionally you express anger when we disagree. Usually it involves a difference of opinion or an unpleasant decision. It is never easy to endure your forceful analogies or well-thought-out invectives, but no matter how unpleasant or demeaning the diatribe, I must always align my will with the God who created you and graciously brought you to me. To know and understand the inspired instructions of the Most High God demands absolute dedication first to God, then to you, and last of all, to myself. If your requests are out of alignment with His holy plan for us, I must cleave to His infallible wisdom, for each of us digress from the straight and narrow way at times. His coming is promised, and He will forever occupy His God-planned, given, and guaranteed position throughout all eternity. If you were to leave, I am one with you, even if you remove yourself from us. You are the mother of the man-child, and as such, are an absolute component in the plan God has for us. What can I do except to wait for our omniscient God to reason with you and bring you back to us, that is the Lord and I, just as He reasoned with Gomer, the unfaithful wife of the prophet Hosea? Or how can you fulfill your destiny in the man-child without the father whom God chose for your child? He gave us a love above all our expectations. It is when you upbraid me that I know you truly love God and our relationship with me. Deep love involves deep passion. The delay in the plan of God generates frustration often. We grow impatient for resolution and the demise of Satan and his legions. It will come when we least expect it. Shall we be angry with God or Christ because they delay? Or shall we give thanks for the delay and know we are one day closer to our destiny? Waiting and willing to wait for God's plan for us, your Kohane. Yeah, there will be times in our married life when there will be disagreements. Some things have to be worked out with patience, and most of all with love one for another. But God will always show the way if we stand on the word and look for the truth. For He is a truth-bearing God, and He is the giver of life. With truth comes life. And so let's give thanks that He had an integral part in the selection of our mates. And in the beginning, when He created Eve for Adam, He brought the perfect mate. And now, we're going to do an Anne Murray song, Could I Have This Dance? I'll always remember the song they were playing the first time we danced, and I knew as we swayed to the music and held to each other. I fell in love with you. Could I have this dance for the rest of my life? Could you be my partner every night? When we're together, it feels so right. Could I have this dance for the rest of my life? I'll always remember that magic moment when I held you close. I knew forever you're all I'll ever need. Could I have this dance for the rest of my life? Could you be my partner every night? When we're together, so right. Could I have this dance for the rest of my life? Could I have this dance for the rest of my life? Could you be my partner every night when God planned it, folks. His plan is always best, and it requires us to align our fallible will with the infallible will of the Most High God through His Son, Jesus Christ. You know, you see, the little things that we do, God's involved in those. So often we think we got to be in church to be holy. And God said, be holy as I am holy. And just remember this, folks. God never asks more of us than we are capable of doing. Be obedient, serve the Lord, and know that when you love your family and friends in godly love, that God's in the middle of it. He is alive and well. He's not way off in some long distant universe. He's as close as a prayer in the center of our mind, our will, and our heart. And now, my dear friends, may the Lord, even the Most High God, be with you in all that you think, say, do, and are. Thank you, my dear friends, for being. And God willing, we'll see you again soon.